I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one.
To Mrs. Saville, Margaret, you will rejoice to hear that no disaster has accompanied my commencement of my permanent residence here. I write these few lines in haste. I found a man unconscious near my home, and I am sheltering him for now. His name is Victor Frankenstoopid. You were out for a while. You mind telling me how you wound up passed out in front of my house?
Where am I? Who are you?
My name is Robert Walton. You're in my house. Are you okay?
I'm a bit fuzzy, that's all.
Alright, you mind telling me how you got here?
No, I don't remember. But I do know what I have to do. It all started a few months ago.
I was on the verge of an amazing discovery. I was creating human life.
Yes, perfect!
There's a refrigerator right over there.
Ooh, bacon.
Cheese.
My goodness, he's evolving faster than everything I've ever seen. It's incredible.
There's so much good stuff in here, man.
It truly was incredible. I had created a living, breathing man, but I was terrified. What was this creature capable of? He was so grotesque and monstrous that...
He sounds pretty harmless to me.
Will you not interrupt me? I'm trying to tell a story here.
Okay.
Okay, now where was I? Ah. I tried to keep the monster away from any human sight while I studied it more, but inevitably my wife found out about the existence of the monster. She was absolutely horrified.
I'm home! Ooh, Victor! Who's your little friend?
Elizabeth, you weren't supposed to come home early.
Well, here I am! Hello, what's your name?
I don't actually have a name.
I haven't given him one yet.
Wait, you didn't give him a name?
No.
Who is he?
He's my creation. I created him.
You created him?
Indeed I did.
And you didn't give him a name? That's terrible! Let's name you Igor.
Igor.
Done.
Interesting.
We've gotta go public with this! You made history!
Igor.
The monster became an overnight celebrity. It was everywhere, all over the news. He was loathed by everyone. He became so infamous, we even went on a talk show.
Hi, I'm Justine Morris, and today we have two very special guests, Victor Frankenstein and his fabulous creation, Igor.
It's great to be here, Justine.
It's great to have you both. Now, contrary to popular belief, Victor Frankenstupid is not the creature. Anyone who thinks that is wrong. You're all wrong. Two very different people. Thank you. Now, Igor, how do you feel about this sudden popularity that you've recently gotten?
Honestly, I'm really hungry.
You know, I don't know what's more amazing, Victor. The fact that you created such a phenomenal creation, or the fact that your last name is Frankenstoopid.
Justine,
it's pretty ironic, isn't it?
Okay. I don't understand what's so scary about this monster anyways. And how have I not heard of any of this news?
Dude, I'm trying to tell a story here. Like, can you not?
Okay.
Okay, now where was I? Ah, yes. The problems were steadily increasing. At one point, the monster even tried breaking into my own home. I knew you were trouble all along.
I'm sorry. Did I wake you?
Die, you monster! After that, I woke up the next day, and my wife and the monster were gone. I can only imagine where he is now.
Wait. So, how did you wind up in front of my house then?
Dude, quit interrupting me. It's not cool.
Okay, fine. Sheesh.
Now, I can only imagine where he is now. He's probably killed my wife. It's all my fault.
He sprung from the cabin window as he said this upon ice raft which lay close to the vessel. He was soon borne away by the waves and lost in darkness and distance. Darkness.
Have you seen Victor anywhere, Igor?
I'm not quite sure, to be honest. I mean, he left when we were gone this morning.
He'll probably turn up sooner or later. He's always off on his adventures. No, no, don't leave me. Oh. He has quite the imagination anyway.
Tell me about it.
I need to find him. Here's what he looks like.
Oh, I just saw him down at Taco Bell. He was just eating there. Abnormally large amount of food, if I do say so myself.
Wait, you're serious?
Yeah.
Good luck! Thank you! Too hot? Hot damn! Got the police and the fireman, I'm too hot! Hot damn! Make a dragon wanna retire, man, I'm too hot! Hot damn! There you are.
Wondering where you were. Me and Elizabeth went grocery shopping this morning while you were knocked out. I was a little hungry, so I just decided to get some Taco Bell.
Wait. Elizabeth is okay. You didn't kill her.
No. Why would I kill her?
Oh, thank goodness.
What's his problem?